All right. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Relax Teams Lunch and Learn series. This is another topic that's dealing with goal setting. We've got a few panelists that'll be discussing some questions that I have for them. And first up, we're going to talk with Lisa. Lisa, do you mind just introducing yourself and telling us a little bit about yourself first?
Absolutely. Thank you, Paul. Sure. Yes, my name is Lisa DeVoren, and I am thrilled to help anyone that's looking to regain their health and lose weight. I am a lifestyle consultant with a company called Vfinity, which is absolutely an amazing company. And there's so much confusion out there with weight loss and wellness that this company cuts through this confusion and has a simple plan with scientifically backed small lifestyle changes that can have a huge impact on your life. And one example of that is to start your day with a glass of lemon water or water at a minimum. And why is that so important? Because during the night, your organs become dehydrated and you want your organs to show up for you for every day for several decades to come. So it's a really small change that can have a really large impact on your life. This plan, I do target, it's really for everyone, but my target market is really anyone 40 plus. And I'd be happy to help anyone that wants to learn more about it. So, you know, just reach out to me.
Okay. So health and wellness is a great thing because people always have goals that deal with that. Next, Candido.
Hi. My name is Candido Rodriguez. I'm a financial advisor with Northwestern Mutual. And what I do and what I'm passionate about is helping people reach those goals. Personal goals they have and they try for. And the way we do is by helping them figure out which are the necessary steps to reach them out and create a plan, personalized and unique, that will take them further than they've ever been. The way we do that is by making sure their financial goals align their personal goals at certain time, and it has to do everything from education planning, retirement, or even if that dream vacation.
Yeah. So I think everybody has goals around financials and their issues and what they want to achieve. So thank you for being on the panel as well. And last up, but certainly not least, Dennis.
Yeah, my name is Dennis Harabin. I'm a CPA. I'm an alumni of Villanova University with their business school and alumni of Deloitte & Touche and Ernst & Young, or Deloitte now and EY. So two of the big four I've worked for. My firm is Relax Tax. I obsess about helping people to retain more of what they earn. So it's all about, it's not so much what you make, it's what you keep. And that's what we're all about, is trying to help people keep as much of what they make through tax and other planning.
Okay. And to follow up with that, Dennis, a lot of times there's going to be challenges between balancing personal as well as your professional goals. So how, as a business owner, do you handle this?
Well, reality is there, when depending on what field you're in, you really can't separate them. I mean, it's part of what you do and who you are. I mean, being an accountant is part of what I am. Obsessing about helping people is what I am. What I do is make sure that I can work it around my family. And I adjust my career around my family. My number one goal is my little daughter and my family. I mean, that's what's most important to me, and making sure that I can put food on the table, things of that help. It kind of helps with that. But mostly it's about, I have a website, earnyourjellybean.com. For me, when I do my job, it's all about making sure I can look my daughter in the eye. Not only can I spend time with my daughter, but I want to be able to earn my jelly bean. I want to have a legacy that my daughter is proud to say, I was her father. And by treating people right and being that trusted professional, that she won't be embarrassed, clients will be happy, everyone wins.
Okay, thanks. How about you, Candido? How do you manage that balance between professional and personal?
Well, it's as Dennis mentioned, it's very unlikely that you'll be able to separate them. However, it's mostly I have a plan. So I plan my day ahead of time. So I know when my day starts, when my day finish. I have days dedicated to certain activities. where if I'm in family mode, I forward, I let my clients know, and I forward that phone call to either a voicemail or to or my assistant. But yeah, they are since they are very intertwined, because in what I do, it's for me, it's important that my clients are okay, as well as my family. So I feel like they are part of my extended network, my extended family. So, but yeah, that's mostly.
Am I back?
Yeah.
You're back, Paul. We can see you. Can you hear us?
Yeah.
We can see you. Can you hear us, Paul?
Yep, I can hear you. Sorry about that. I don't know what happened. Okay. Lisa, and balancing for you.
So thank you. And yes, and so I think really what helps for me is that I do what I love, right? So they often intertwine, but I do need to plan also. And I think that if you have your personal goals and they you take the time for them and make them a priority, you will have your health. And if you have your health, your business will strive. You'll have the energy, the focus, you know, all of those things to project your business forward. So, but for me, I have a plan for both. I make sure that it's flexible because I know that it needs to be, especially in today's world with everything virtual. And I adjust it, you know, I revisit. The other thing is that I revisit those goals typically like on a monthly basis and make adjustments where necessary to keep myself accountable.
So speaking of which, how do you help others with their goals?
So I'm in the wellness business, right? So I need to know what their goals are, what are their main wellness goals? And I need them to be ready to take that, to commit and to be ready to view their health as a priority. And once I do that, I can help educate them with the knowledge that I've learned and show them ways and point out things that they can do to change their life, to give them that health that they are seeking.
Thank you. Dennis, you're obsessed. How do you help people? So maybe you want them obsessed or you don't want them obsessed.
No, I always tell people, you know, it's your goal, and whether you do it or not, people are you going to be on me? You're going to harass me? No, I mean, if you don't do it, that's on you. You know, I'm not babysitting, you're an adult. But what I'm going to do is we have the tools, the process, and the expertise and the, to get it done for you and to help you. So we actually structure, everyone gets their own plan. So we're not just doing a tax return for anyone. I mean, that's easy. There's three main things that drive someone's financial health. And it's, you know, the three leverage points that make the difference between, are you just getting by? Are you living check by check? Or are you actually getting to really where you need to be? And those three things are taxes, insurance, and debt. And the three of them work in harmony. And if you're not syncing them all together, you get held down and the man's holding you back. So what we do is we come walk through, and first we have to understand, just like Lisa said, we understand who you are. If I don't know who you are and I don't know what your goals are, it doesn't matter what your goals are, we're going to help you find them. We're going to help you reach them. And we're going to set a plan in action, and we're going to give you the tools you need. Every piece of paper you get, everything you have, you stick in here. Then you never show this to me because I don't ever want to see paper. We have a totally mobile device where you take the pictures of all that, and we walk it through the process. And now we've got a virtual vault for you. And we remind you when you're supposed to do what you're supposed to do. If you don't do it, well, that's on you. But we're going to give you the process now to reach that goal. And then at the end, we're going to review your tax return and say, hey, here's what we could have done better. And then we're going to do that year after year. And in the end, if I'm not saving you more than you paid me, like exponentially more, my advice to you as your trusted financial professional is fire me, because I'm costing you money. Now you're not retaining more of what you earn. So fire me, but I'm going to save you more along the way. That's the way I do it.
Okay. Thanks. So from one financial person to another, Candido, point, counterpoint, do you agree? Do you disagree? Do you do things differently?
I agree. But I'm like Dennis, I'm more like I have to be on the babysitting part, because what I try to do when it comes to goal setting and make sure that my clients stay on track, it's not only that they have a written plan or in paper. It also like trying to having learned those good habits. Me as a business owner, having a family, sometimes it's hard to keep and stay focused, but most of the time, like the easiest way to achieve those goals is by introducing those changes. For instance, and I'm no expert, Lisa will be better expert, but if you want to lose 100 pounds in a year, it sounds a lot, but it's only around 8 pounds a month. So knowing that makes it easier and to know whether I'm tracking or my clients are tracking for their goals, or if we are left behind, or even if we are, if we're on point in a point where we can increase that goal, or if we have to make sure that we, manage expectations. But my main idea is to try to have my clients build their goals into their routine. I agree with Dennis on if you don't have it in paper, it's not gonna happen. But it has to become part of your daily life. 43% of the people do their goals while thinking or while doing other things. So it's easy to get distracted, and particularly once you're tired or you feel like you're not achieving anything, to go back and into the old habits and most of them, that's what got you wherever you are, whether it is you're deep in debt or you're not saving enough for retirement. You're late for college planning, or even you don't have any kind of insurance. If something were to happen and you have your guard down. So that's what I do with most of my clients. We build among the plans the habits that they need in order to reach their goals.
So Lisa, if I'm not going to be losing 100 pounds. But if I do, do you find that it's easier, or do you support people as a group or individually? What's the best way that you get support with your clients?
Yeah, so I really use both individual and group, but the focus really is on group. Because a lot of times people want to watch from the sideline. They're afraid to jump in. I get it. They're afraid of failure. Think it's going to be too hard. So a lot of times, if you can watch other people's victories and their failures and learn from them, it's easier to keep those goals and keep them, and achieve them. So it's largely group, but I definitely do talk to people one-on-one. And if people need to be held accountable on a weekly basis, I'm happy to touch base with them and make sure that they're able to reach their goals. And if you know that you're going to be talking to me on Sunday, Friday night, you might not have that extra glass of wine.
Okay. Candido, in the financial industry, can you work with groups or individuals, or how do you do that?
Usually it's, our approach in my practice is on an individual basis, but if it's, if I take it as a family, we include everybody. Like if we can have the kids bring it into the conversation so they understand that that 1 hour lunch hour takes money they're spending, literally down the drain. We integrate the family as a group in that sense. Having the wife on a plan and the husband in another plan is not gonna take us anywhere. So yeah, we bring as a family as into the plan, but it's mostly on an individual basis.
Okay. And Dennis?
Well, with us, there's nothing more personal than someone's taxes, and that's why you have to trust who's doing it. Because when I see someone's taxes, I can tell you a lot about your financial things. A lot of times people don't even know that I know just by looking at, because the math and the numbers all make sense. So that's why we go back to the application and the app that we have. The hardest part is getting that information in a secure manner to make sure that we can maintain it, retain it, and you can get it and you can only share it. You do want to share that information with people, but you don't want to share it with everyone. But there's times you're going to want to share it. So what we are able to do is with our software and our tool is to, you take a picture of it. It turns it into a PDF. It goes into our file vault. Clients call me all the time to say, where's this? They're asking me where all their things are. And I have them for them. It's on their smartphone. They can get to it. Most of the times they can find it, but it takes me 2 seconds to show it with them. So it is always 100% one-on-one until a customer asks, or a client asks, Can you talk to this person? Can you? And I also often become the conduit between multiple professionals. I like to view myself as the architect. I'm not going to build your financial. I'm not going to have the products. Candido has the products. Chris has the products. There are people who have the tools. There are people who have the different pieces. I don't sell you the insurance. There's someone who, I tell you what type of insurance to get. And then you go out and buy the product. So often I'm invited into those conversations, and I'm glad to have those conversations. But it always starts one-on-one. And then we take it from where you want to go as the client.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, everybody. I appreciate your time, Lisa, Candido, Dennis. Thanks for your insights.
Thanks, Paul. Thanks for hosting.
Yeah.